Nithyanand, guys. Welcome back to the channel. I welcome you all with my love and respects and the blessings of my Guru, His Divine Holiness, Bhagwan Sri Nityananda Paramashiva. Today I wanted to make a small video about the space of how, when you're stuck in a pattern, if you see, okay, if you have, if you realize that you're stuck in a pattern in your life, something that somehow you're not ferocious enough with yourself to go beyond it. I realized Swamiji, he was talking about prayerfulness, right? And he described prayerfulness as being passion with patience. And that's, for me, it really clicked, because also in the past, he also gave the definition of seeking, which was also intensity with tremendous intensity with tremendous love and patience. And then I realized, oh my God, actually seeking and prayerfulness is actually the same space. There's an intensity, passion, and there is a deep love and patience. So it is, and it's also, so I was able to map the whole thing, seeing that, oh, and it's also when Swamiji was introducing this, E is not equal to MC squared, he was saying it's intensity and continuity. So that is the space we have to get into. And one thing that is very powerful is when you are stuck in a pattern and you feel your energy is low and, you know, you're not active, alive, fresh, radiating, alert, quick, and all that, just getting into this deep prayerful mood with a real strong desire for inviting the energy of the master and the master inside of us, so that he can come and, you know, remove the blockages, remove the pattern, and allow the energy to come back to a high state. So having this intense passion, this intense desire, yearning for the master to come, and so the grace of the master to come and remove the blockages, and at the same time patience, meaning that, you know, sometimes it happens quickly, sometimes it takes a little bit more time, but in the whole process, not getting agitated in any way, and just remaining patient and very loving towards ourselves while engaging in this deep, intense passion. And for me, that is a very a meaningful and powerful thing, because we are taught, or we believe, you know, you have to be intense or you are patient. So people most of the time, you know, will be in situations where like, okay, it takes time. But most of the time when we use this understanding or this cognition, it takes time, we drop the intensity. And sometimes when we're intense, super intense, but when we don't get the result as fast as we want, you know, we get agitated, we get irritated, angry, or sad, depressed, and all that. And then we drop it. So no, actually the space that, you know, constantly cognizing and cherishing and wanting to get into is a space of deep intensity and deep love and patience. And like that, we raise the frequency of our being and of our body, allowing higher energy to be awakened and allowing us to be receptive to the grace of the Guru, of Paramashiva. So yeah, that's something that I wanted to share with you guys. If you feel stuck somewhere in some form of pattern, just connect to Swamiji in that deep oneness, deep prayerfulness, and intensely have this intense passion towards invoking His grace, His energy, His blessings upon you, so that, you know, that pattern can be broken. And it's very simple, and we can do it anywhere. I mean, it doesn't require anything. It's just a desire, an intention, really, an intention to just make it happen with intensity and patience. So yeah, that was the click I had recently, wanted to share with you guys. So whenever you feel low, if you feel you're stuck, you know, you kind of see yourself in the way you exist, in the way you flow, you feel that, you know, at some point you constantly hit that kind of stagnation or dullness or, you know, tiredness or boredom, then at these moments, remembering actually all moments, but unfortunately, initially, we always remember God when we are down, when we are high, excited, we don't remember. But when we're low, we do. So actually, no, we have to remember it both ways. When we are low, we seek His blessings to high. And when we are high, we offer our gratitude for the energy that we have. And like that, we get into this, we go beyond ups and downs, and we experience that state of bliss in a more and more frequent level until we become fully established in that space of bliss, which becomes eternal bliss, Nityananda. So, yes, that's what I wanted to share with you guys today. So I'll see you guys soon. Subscribe, like, leave a comment below if you have a question, or if it, you know, you feel connected to this truth, or if you have an experience of this truth. And watch us every day after Satsang. We go live on the Blissful Athletes YouTube channel. We do a Varkyata Sadas, which is a kind of a, it's not a debate, it's a spiritual debate with the purpose of raising our cognition, raising our understanding. It's not about, you know, bringing somebody down and you win, you lose. It's about whomever is established in the highest space regarding the topic, well, that person enriches everybody and bring everybody to that space. So yes, inviting you to come check it out on the Blissful Athletes channel after Satsang. And with this, I'll see you guys soon. Nithyanandam.
I welcome you all with my love and respect. Let you all open all your three eyes